when the team said, okay, you can come now from Buzios, we're ready for you, was about a 6-hour row. And I thought, you know, after I've just been sitting here for like a day and a half, how the heck am I going to be able to do this now? And I got out there and I was fine. I was feeling, you know, I looked at myself and I thought, just like, we're all the same. Everybody's the same. There's nobody, it doesn't matter who you are in life, nobody's special or more special than anybody else. The thing that differentiates one person from another person is your dreams and the action that you take on those dreams. And that is, you know, what my message is now to everybody is, dream big, do big, and don't let anybody discourage you from doing something completely different. Don't be afraid to take a risk. Okay. You know, I really appreciate that, you know, I did also post in one of my blog posts that when people go out to do a sports event or something like that, the support that you get from the people in the stands, in the crowd, are actually absolutely critical to that. If nobody would have noticed, hell no, I wouldn't have done the row. So I really appreciate the support and the encouragement and the acknowledgement. Approaching the Brazilian coast, I needed to have one more day to get closer to the coast with the trade winds that blows from Africa to South America, to get to the right position for my turn southwest towards Cabo Frio. And I was still 60 miles too far offshore, so I wasn't properly in the northeasterly winds that would push me down. And the problem was, if I couldn't get into those northeasterlies, I would continue south to the Falklands. So that was quite an issue for me, because I had to fight for about a week to get closer to the coast, to get into those northeasterly winds. You know, the way that I managed to get through that was I focused on what my goal was for the row. I just kept on reminding myself what I wanted to achieve out of the row, and focused on that, visualizing the outcome, the positive outcome. So, and the mind is an incredible thing. Whenever you are in a situation where you are feeling stressed and out of sorts and feel that you can't cope, you can actually, generally we refer to that as daydreaming, you know. It's the same thing. Make a daydream. Take yourself into a scenario or a situation where you feel happy and comfortable and energized, and disassociate from your current situation. And that is exactly what I did. So this is my cabin, where I sleep, where everything is. On this side I have a charge controller that controls the power that comes from the solar panels, and a switchboard that distributes the power to the different systems on board the boat. I also have batteries, which is stored and sealed underneath the deck. So the solar panels will charge the batteries, and then the charge controller will either take the power from the batteries or from the solar panels. On this side is all my navigation equipment and my maritime radio, and then I also have charging points and sockets for my satellite communication system, and anything else that I need to charge to operate. I also have an inverter, so I can generate 220 volts, but my systems all operate on 12 volts. The other equipment that I also operate from the batteries and from the solar panels is a water maker, a desalinator. The desalinator takes seawater and pushes it through a very fine membrane, and the salt, the brine, goes back into the sea, and the fresh water I can then capture for my drinking water. And that is in a compartment at the back, and the water maker itself, the membranes, is right at the bottom here at the end of my feet. Behind me is a compartment where my food is stored. I was glad that the media boat and Gonzalo, my media guy here in Brazil, he was in the media boat with a lot of other journalists, but they were just too far away. I was bawling my eyes out. I mean, when I think about it now, I want to start crying again. It was that whole, just that experience, you know, to waving the flag and the flare and the reality setting in. Oh my, it's done. It's over. I've done it. I've achieved it. It's like, did I really achieve it? Flipping hell, yes, I did. No, it was emotional. It was crazy, crazy, crazy. It was unbelievable. Okay, can I have, okay, yeah, let me try that one. And I want to try the pistachio.
Yeah.
Oh, that is good. Can I try it? Yeah. No, that one.
Yes.
I want one of those. Just a small, yeah.
Yeah,
para o passo e o amarelo.